host is the most familiar is more. That's right, we're here at Slate on 21st Street for yet another Comedy Spillage show. That's right, if you're ready for gut-busting, stomach-holding laughter, this is the place to be. Although I know this lovely face needs no introduction, I'm going to introduce him anyway. It is none other than the romantic funny man of comedy, Mr. Sean Cornelius.
It's me. It's me. I'm back.
Sean, three times in a row, man. We're doing it.
This is it. It's getting bigger and better every single time. But this show is going to be hot, though.
Yes.
Coordinating the show with the comics and everything, we got a fantastic lineup. We got Mugga, David Foster, A.G. White, Capone, Dana Dane, Allison Williams. More special acts coming through.
Trevor Bonner from Bonafide Entertainment. Get prepared for life. If you don't know, now you know. Welcome, Comedy Spillage number un, dos, tres. Three times. They say third time's a charm. Trevor, talk to me.
Something like that, but we doing it up right here at Slate, 54 West 21st Street. Of course, we got Buzz Bill, a million more. Beautiful and sexy as always. Unlike no any other comedy show, trust me. This is just not a show, this is an event. This is an extravaganza. There's good people here. You can mingle. You ain't got to worry about a little spillage, as we call it, you know. But it's a very good thing, and we're trying to really keep it going, you know?
But, you know, that's the thing that I wanted to talk to you about, because I'm looking around the room, and I'm seeing people talking, sitting, chilling, eating, playing pool. I mean, there's so much going on. How do you get, like, such a nice, eclectic crowd? I mean, is it the message, is it the vibe, or is it you?
I guess, really, honestly, I guess you could put it as being me.
Let's hear it for Sean Cornelius.
Come on, let's hear it for Sean Cornelius. You heard the lady. Now, I went hard to get some damn credit. Turn it up, they can't feel that. I have to go back to the old school.
Wow.
We got old school artists in the house.
I have one of the promoters of the show, none other than Craig. Craig, welcome back for the third time. We're doing it big, Craig.
We're trying, you know. I'm glad for all the people who came out to support myself and Trevor. You know, we keep doing this for you. Everybody's loving it. This is what we do, Comedy Spillage.
You guys are from Greece. You're from Greece. And when did you get married? Dominica? Dominica. You got married. You married last week? How long you known each other?
A year and a half.
A year and a half? You're like, I ain't got no time to waste. Let's get this shit together, huh? Fantastic. And you're honeymooning in New York? Why are you here? You should be in a room somewhere. Ran out of Viagra, didn't you? I know. Y'all give it up for him. Happy honeymoon. Congratulations. Thank you guys for coming. Dominica Flash, shake my hand. Okay. You're welcome. Don't kiss me too hard.
The icon. If you really know hip hop, I don't need to say anymore. But for you youngins from the new school, this is the true school, y'all. Dana Dane. What's up, Dana?
How you doing? Blessing and love.
Man, always love. Always love. Now, you got to talk to me about what this pink is, brother.
I was doing my thing for the breast cancer walk, you know. And, you know, a lot of our mothers, sisters, cousins, aunts, nieces are affected by cancer, breast cancer every year. I have been personally affected over the last 3 years, and, you know, we just got to bring more awareness.
A legend such as yourself, what valuable information can you give to the young people that are out here trying to make it in this beast that we call the music industry?
Well, I think you start with learning how to brand yourself, but even before that, you got to learn the business of yourself. And you can never get paid what you work if you don't know what you work. So find out, learn what you work so that you don't have to fall into a bad deal. Once you know what you work, then you can get what you work and you can make it happen for yourself.
Well, there you have it. Keep getting ready to grace the stage. There's so much more for you. I keep telling you that. I hope you you believe in me now?
Well, I'm the dang, 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 the dang. Now, I'm the rapper Dana Day, and don't sound great, and I'm gonna give you a little story just to illustrate. I was in my house, and I was all alone. I heard the bring, bring on my telephone. Answered the phone, guess who was on it? This girl, they call it the Susie Bonnie. She said, hello, is this the Casanova? I said, yeah, baby, that's the one to come on over.
She said, not right now, we just got out of the shower. Let me check you out another half an hour.
Time flew fast, and I was still in for her.
Is it your mind if I dance with y'all? This is my song. I don't need your help. So I go to the dance floor and dance by myself. Turn it up.
You don't have to dance with me.
Yeah, as long as I got my 2 feet, I don't need nobody else, cause I'll be dancing by myself. If you wanna dance with me, I'll be up in VIP. It'll be me and no one else, cause I'll be dancing by myself. Y'all say it, dancing by myself. Say what?
Dancing by myself.
Say what?
Dancing by myself.
We're back. That's right, with another guest that is performing tonight. It is none other than David Foster. Welcome, David.
Thank you, thank you.
Now, David, I know you've got a lot prepared for us tonight. Can you give us a little taste of something, or do you want to keep it a secret?
It's not so much that I want to keep it a secret, but I think I'm actually, honestly, will probably spill it out as I go along, as far as like what I'm going to talk about. Yeah, I mean, I'll be choosing from material that already exists, but I don't know exactly what I'm going to talk about.
You know, that's interesting. How do you make that decision? Like, tonight's the night that I got to keep it clean, or tonight's the night I can go all the way in, or how do you know that?
Well, so honestly, sometimes you stereotype the way the crowd physically looks.
From New York, man. I lived in New York my whole life. Every once in a while, I still see some shit I've never seen before. I was on the train the other day. I saw this homeless couple. They were making out with each other. They were really going at it, too. Really, like, slobbing each other down. I was like, come on, man. Get a box, you know?
What? A place that looks this nice, all you people look so beautiful, everybody's dressed so beautiful, the lighting, the cameras, and out of nowhere, you end up having the worst show of your life. There's a rap concert going on behind your head while you talk, nobody laughs, and then some bitch just comes up to me in the middle of my set. Okay, what is this shit? So you go on a date with, like, the most beautiful, brilliant woman in the world. You take her home, she's down to fuck on the first night. Takes out her pants, she got a huge dick. That's a bit, please leave me alone, please. This is going bad enough. You can't help it at all. Although you did actually help. Thank you so much. Round of applause for alcohol. Give it up for alcohol, everybody. Thank God for alcohol when it mixes with stupidity. That is amazing. Thank God that happened. Otherwise, this wouldn't have been interesting at all. I would have just been the fucking bullshit-ass white comedian. All of a sudden, I'm funny.
We have none other than another comedian out here tonight. His name is Corey. Welcome, Corey, to the red carpet.
Hey, what's up? What's going on? How you doing?
How you doing? How you doing? As Madea would say.
Right.
Now, Corey, talk about why you got into comedy, because I've been asking all the comedians that all night long.
Well, basically, I got into comedy because I had nothing else to do. No talent. I had an associate's degree in liberal arts from a community college. In other words, I had 2 high school diplomas. And this was my only option. No, I've loved comedy.
That's cool though, being from Brooklyn, Canarsie. Last stop on the L train. I fucking hate that train. That shit go through all the worst neighborhoods in Brooklyn. Brownsville. You survive that. East New York. Bed-Stuy. You make it all the way to the end. You're in Chelsea. 1 minute you on the L train sitting next to Mobb Deep and G-Unit. You fall asleep, wake up, you sitting next to Lady Gaga and 3 vampires. But bitch, get the fuck off my neck. Women think because I'm Puerto Rican, I love to go down. They're looking at me, so where are you, Puerto Rican? Woo! Yeah, papi. Hook me up, do what Puerto Rican guys do. I went outside and stole that bitch's car. driving off with that shit, like, suavemente. Thank y'all, man. Y'all been great. Y'all been great.
What's up? We're back. That's right. Your host is the most familiar is more. And it ain't about mugshots. It's about this beautiful face. Her name is Mugga. Welcome to the building.
How you doing? Thanks for having me.
Now, Mugga, talk about Precious, because everybody knows. How was that?
It was excellent. I had a very small part in a really big film. If you guys know, it was Precious. Mr. Lee Daniels directed. And people always saying, which one were you? Where were you in the movie? I was the one she stole the fried chicken from. That was me, and she got cursed out.
Give me that chicken back. How dare you?
And some other stuff. Expletive. Yeah. Quite a few.
Few adjectives that we're editing right now, right? Now, Comic View, BET, HBO. No, you're not old. You're fabulous.
A long time ago, I started out.
What got you into comedy?
A dare. A friend of mine, very famous comedian, Will Sylvan, he dared me to do it.
Oh, I know that.
Yeah. And he used to come into a store that I worked in. He's like, you're really funny. You should give it a try. And I've been doing it ever since.
Now, what was the gamble on the dare? I mean, did you get anything from it?
A career.
This is what we're going to do. Can you drop something that's going to make everybody just relax? No, not suave mente. This ain't supposed to bring y'all asses up here. This is not supposed to happen this way. It was supposed to make you go in the back room. Where else do you do this shit at? Do you go to the movie theater and just get the fuck up in front of the screen? You can't just keep coming up here. No. We'll give you a situation later.
Give me that place.
Give you the what? Give you the place so you can get some? Did he just grab her titty in front of everybody? Go in the, there's a room. See where that exit sign is back there? Back in the corner. Walk that way. Give them some walking music. Play that shit again. And you know the bad shit about it? Y'all laughing like this shit is funny. Keep going. Please welcome my friend, Mugga!
I think I'm Big Meat, Larry Hoover, whipping work, hallelujah, one nation.
Everybody from Brooklyn thinks they're thugs, right? Under God, how y'all doing? Anybody look like a thug ain't a thug. Some of it is thug byproducts. They not really thugging. They faking. They think because they wear their pants hanging off their ass that makes them a thug. No, that makes you stupid. Pull up your fucking pants. They think because they wear Timberland boots that makes them a thug. No. You are not a construction worker. You did not lay no bricks. Why are your boots clean? Put on some shoes and go with the shit you did. If you didn't do shit all day, put on some hush puppies and shut the fuck up. You don't have a job. You don't work nowhere. Stop playing. I don't like how they approach me anymore anyway. I didn't decide that I was too old for them. They let me know I was too old for them. You know how it is in New York. You're walking down the street. I don't care how old you are, what color you are. They all want to holler at you. It's the same shit. You go into the train station. 6:30 in the morning, this motherfucker's in the train station. You get off work 6:30 at night, they still standing there. They did not go to work. But the way they approach you is the same. It's like, oh, let me holler at you, boo. That's normal. They let me know some shit the other day. I walk into the train station. This little disrespectful motherfucker's going to say, excuse me. Ma'am, can I talk to you, ma'am? I said, who the fuck is ma'am? Call me Shorty, son. You mad disrespectful. Mad disrespectful. I live by the rules. Don't say nothing to me. I didn't say nothing to you. He didn't stop there. I don't know if y'all experienced it, but the older you get, the hormones get fucked up. You start growing hair in places you shouldn't have hair, right? I got a little mustache. That's all right. It's mine. I ain't the only fucking one. But he complained about it. Come on, look at you. You look like a damn dude. You need to wax your shit. I'm thinking to myself, I pay the bills. One of us got to be the man. I don't have the fucking mustache. This is Con Edison. This is Cable Vision. This is the insurance. This is the car note. That's the groceries.